Duloxetine is a serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor used to treat generalized anxiety disorder, neuropathic pain, osteoarthritis, and stress incontinence. In this video, let's find found. What is duloxetine? What is duloxetine used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking duloxetine? How does duloxetine work? How to use duloxetine? What is duloxetine? Duloxetine, sold under the brand name Cymbalta among others, is a medication used to treat major depressive disorder, generalized anxiety disorder, fibromyalgia, neuropathic pain, and central sensitization. It is taken by mouth. Duloxetine is a serotonin, norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor. Duloxetine is a serotonin, norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor, SNRI. Similarly to SSRIs and other SNRIs, the precise mechanism for its antidepressant and anxiolytic effects is not known. Duloxetine was approved for medical use in the United States and in the European Union in 2004. It is available as a generic medication. In 2020, it was the 27th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 22 million prescriptions. What is duloxetine used for? Indicated for 1. Management of major depressive disorder. 2. Management of generalized anxiety disorder. 3. Management of diabetic peripheral neuropathy. 4. Management of fibromyalgia. 5. Management of chronic musculoskeletal pain. 6. Management of osteoarthritis of the knee in adults. 7. Management of chronic lower back pain in adults. 8. Management of stress urinary incontinence in adult women. Off-label uses include 1. Management of chemotherapy-induced peripheral neuropathy. 2. Management of stress urinary incontinence in adult men after prostatectomy until recovery is complete. Contraindication. The following contraindications are listed by the manufacturer. Hypersensitivity. Duloxetine is contraindicated in patients with a known hypersensitivity to duloxetine or any of the inactive ingredients. Monoamine oxidase inhibitors, MAOIs, concomitant use in patients with MAOIs is contraindicated. Uncontrolled narrow-angle glaucoma. In clinical trials, Cymbalta use was associated with an increased risk of mydriasis, dilation of the pupil. Therefore, its use should be avoided in patients with uncontrolled narrow-angle glaucoma, in which mydriasis can cause sudden worsening. Central nervous system, CNS, acting drugs. Given the primary CNS effects of duloxetine, it should be used with caution when it is taken in combination with or substituted for other centrally acting drugs, including those with a similar mechanism of action. Duloxetine and thioridazine should not be co-administered. Side effects: nausea, vomiting, constipation, diarrhea, weight changes, heartburn, stomach pain, decreased appetite. Pharmacodynamic. Duloxetine, through increasing serotonin and norepinephrine concentrations in Onuf's nucleus, enhances glutamatergic activation of the pudendal motor nerve, which innervates the external urethral sphincter. This enhanced signaling allows for stronger contraction. Increased contraction sphincter increases the pressure needed to produce an incontinence episode in stress urinary incontinence. Duloxetine has been shown to improve patient global impression of improvement and incontinence quality of life scores. It has also been shown to reduce the median incontinence episode frequency at doses of 40 and 80 mg. Action at the horn of the spinal cord allows duloxetine to strengthen the serotonergic and adrenergic pathways involved in descending inhibition of pain. This results in an increased threshold of activation necessary to transmit painful stimuli to the brain and effective relief of pain, particularly in neuropathic pain. Pain relief has been noted in a variety of painful conditions, including diabetic peripheral neuropathy, fibromyalgia, and osteoarthritis, using a range of pain assessment surveys. While duloxetine has been shown to be effective in both animal models of mood disorders and in clinical trials for the treatment of these disorders in humans, the broad scope of pharmacodynamic effects on mood regulation in the brain has yet to be explained. Increased blood pressure is a common side effect with duloxetine due to vasoconstriction mediated by the intended increase in norepinephrine signaling. Mechanism of action. Duloxetine is a potent inhibitor of neuronal serotonin and norepinephrine reuptake and a less potent inhibitor of dopamine reuptake. Duloxetine has no significant affinity for dopaminergic, adrenergic, cholinergic, histaminergic, opioid, glutamate, and GABA receptors. Action on the external urinary sphincter is mediated via duloxetine's CNS effects. Increased serotonin and norepinephrine concentrations in Onuf's nucleus leads to increased activation of 5-HT2, 5-HT3, and alpha-1 adrenergic receptors. 5-HT2 and alpha-1 are both U-coupled and their activation increases the activity of the inositol trisphosphate/phospholipase C, IP3/PLC, pathway. This pathway leads to release of intracellular calcium stores, increasing intracellular calcium concentrations, and facilitating neuronal excitability. 5-HT3 functions as a ligand-gated sodium channel, which allows sodium to flow into the neuron when activated. Increased flow of sodium into the neuron contributes to depolarization and activation of voltage-gated channels involved in action potential generation. The combined action of these three receptors contributes to increased ability of the pudendal motor nerve in response to glutamate. The mechanisms involved in duloxetine's benefits in depression and anxiety have not been fully elucidated. Dysfunctional serotonin and norepinephrine signaling are thought to be involved and increases in the availability of these neurotransmitters at the synaptic cleft to mediate a therapeutic effect. It is postulated that the involvement of serotonin and norepinephrine in areas responsible for emotional modulation, such as the limbic system, contributes to the effects in mood disorders specifically, but this has yet to be confirmed. Duloxetine's hypertensive effect is related to its intended pharmacological effect. Increased availability of norepinephrine leads to activation of adrenergic receptors on the vascular endothelium. Since the action of alpha-1 receptors predominates, vasoconstriction results as the GQ-coupled receptor mediates calcium release from the sarcoplasmic reticulum to facilitate smooth muscle contraction. Half-life. Mean of 12 H, with a range of 8 to 17. Dose. Major depressive disorder. Indicated for major depressive disorder, MDD. 40 to 60 mg/day PO initially, in single daily dose or divided Q12HR for 1 week if patient needs to adjust to therapy. Consider starting at 30 mg Q-day 1 week to allow for therapy adjustment before increasing to 60 mg Q-day. Target dosage, 60 mg per day PO, not to exceed 120 mg per day. There is no evidence that doses greater than 60 mg per day confer additional benefit. Diabetic peripheral pain. Indicated for diabetic peripheral neuropathy/neuropathic pain. 60 mg PO Q-day initially, in single daily dose or divided Q12HR, consider lowering initial dose if tolerability is a concern. Target dosage, 60 mg per day PO, not exceed 60 mg per day. There is no evidence that doses greater than 60 mg per day confer additional benefit. Consider a lower starting dosage and gradually increase dose for patients with renal impairment. Generalized anxiety disorder. Indicated for generalized anxiety disorder, GAD. Age less than 65 years, 60 mg PO Q-day initially. Consider starting at 30 mg Q-day for 1 week to allow for therapy adjustment before increasing to 60 mg Q-day. Target dosage, 60 mg per day PO Q-day. May increase in increments of 30 mg Q-day, not to exceed 120 mg per day. No additional benefit shown with doses greater than 60 mg per day. Fibromyalgia. Indicated for fibromyalgia. 30 mg PO Q-day initially for 1 week to allow therapy adjustment before increasing to 60 mg Q-day. Target dosage, 60 mg PO Q-day, not to exceed 60 mg per day. No additional benefit shown with doses greater than 60 mg. Chronic musculoskeletal pain. Indicated for chronic musculoskeletal pain, including comfort from osteoarthritis and chronic lower back pain. 30 mg POQ day initially for 1 week to allow for therapy adjustment before increasing to 60 mg Q day. Target dosage, 60 mg per day PO, not to exceed 60 mg per day. Safety advice. Duloxetine is a serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor that is classified as a pregnancy category C drug by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, FDA. That is, there are no adequate and well-controlled studies of duloxetine in pregnant women. That's all the information about duloxetine we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.